Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I want to talk about the point of constexpr and why it matters. I often get pushback on constexpr, and I think I've refined my story for why it matters in your code, and I think we can build on this from a very recent example. So I think this will be a good one. Okay. So the general pushback that I get from people is basically, I don't have work that is known at compile time. And I think what they're thinking is that they've got step one, a million steps, step n, and they say, I don't know all of this at compile time. As C++ developers, we are honored to contribute to self-driving technology, simplify lives with embedded devices, support financial ecosystems, and assist traders with trading bots. To keep up with the pace of development, we need tools that help us work quickly and effectively. CLion is a powerful JetBrains IDE for C and C++ that makes this challenge its main goal, integrating code analysis, refactoring, and the best ecosystem tools into our day-to-day development. Use CPP Weekly CLion to get 25% off when you purchase a new CLion subscription or renew your existing one. Which is probably true. You're probably not working in a problem domain where you can solve literally the entire problem at compile time. Kind of cool if you can, but then you're probably only executing the program once anyhow. Whatever. But you probably actually do know something like steps 1 through M can be known at compile time, and then steps M through N are not known at compile time. So the question is, can you figure out which steps can be done at compile time and which steps must be done at runtime? So I'm going to go back to this state machine that knows how to parse an input string of numbers. I'm going to go ahead and rearrange this. We're going to remove the asserts and the print. And we're just going to return the result. Now, I'm returning a negative number in this case, so we're going to get not the greatest output from Explorer here. As we can see, program returned 224, which is negative 32 wrapped around. I can see that the compiler generated, shall we say, a lot of code. And I've only parsed 3 characters. If I were to parse only 2 characters, the optimizer chooses to do this at compile time, and I can see that negative 3 is returned from main. And that is exactly correct. But I can't do 2 at compile time. It ends up doing the entire thing at runtime. So let's do negative 3210. And we can assume that the compiler is going to choose to do this at runtime, and we can see that it does. In fact, it has explicit calls to the make int parser. Now, let's just say hypothetically, I know that the number that I'm going to parse at compile time starts with negative 3, 2. So I have made a constEval function. This is known as an immediate function. It is one that is going to be always evaluated at compile time. And I'm calling this start parsing. And I create the make int parser. And I parse these first 3 characters. Then I return the parser itself. Then I parse the character 1, then I parse the character 0. So I am parsing 3 characters at compile time and 2 characters at runtime. And we can see that the compiler did all of this at compile time. We already knew that its limit for parsing characters in the optimizer was 2. And now we're doing 5, because 3 of them were guaranteed to happen at compile time, and 2 of them we just kind of asked nicely. So if we were to add yet another parser in here, then what we have is still the first part of this work will be done at compile time, and the remaining work will be done at runtime. Now, for this to work at all, this function had to be constexpr, and the thing that it returns had to be constexpr enabled, and expected had to be constexpr friendly. We had to already have the framework for constexpr in place to be able to do even a part of our problem at compile time. So this is why constexpr matters. This is why I say you need to constexpr enable your libraries. The standard library needs to be enabled at constexpr time, because with constexpr, we can get some sort of guarantee that we can solve the first M steps of the problem that we are working on at compile time, and then only solve the remaining N steps that we know we need at runtime. I mean, there's no reason to do that initial work repeatedly at runtime if it's something that's known at compile time. So that's something to think about. I hope that this was actually an interesting episode for you. So yeah, thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe. I'll see you in the next episode.